The Holy Quran says, "And protect the boundaries in relation to your kin." The word Rahm in this verse refers to one's blood relatives. Silat al-Rahm means to maintain friendly relations with one's blood relatives, and it is a wajib duty on all Muslims, even if their blood relatives do not do the same in return. Qata al-Rahm, on the other hand, means to cut relations with one's blood relatives. This is one of the greatest sins in Islam. The Quran curses people who cut ties in what Allah has ordered to join. A man once asked the Prophet, "What is the worst deed in the eyes of Allah?" The Prophet replied, "To associate partners to Allah." Then the man asked, "After this, what is the worst sin?" The Prophet then said, "To cut ties with relatives." According to narrations, scholars have said there are different grades of Silat al-Rahm. The highest stage of Silat al-Rahm is to consider our relatives as our own selves. That is, if we wish something for ourselves, we should also wish it for our relatives. Another stage of Silat al-Rahm is to help relatives overcome the difficulties and hardships they may be facing. This may be giving them a loan, helping them find jobs, advising them in matters of religion, and so on. The simplest kind of Silat al-Rahm may be calling them to say salam, or even conveying our salam to them through someone. Sometimes we may be in doubt whether our behavior is considered as Silat al-Rahm or Qata al-Rahm. In such cases, we should go by what the sensible common person generally view that behavior to be, as long as it doesn't contradict Islamic teachings. For example, if we live in a society where not saying salam or calling someone is seen as breaking ties with them, then doing this with our relatives would constitute Qata al-Rahm, and so on. What if your relatives don't want to keep ties with you? According to Islamic law, breaking ties with your relatives is haram, even if they want to. Every situation is different, but one should maintain some sort of tie to the best of their ability, even if it is sending a text message. What if your relatives are not Muslim? The traditions of Ahlul Bayt leave no doubt whatsoever that the fulfilling of the rights of one's relatives is wajib. Whether the relatives are Shia or Sunni, pious, religious, Muslims or non-Muslims, it is wajib to maintain ties with them to the degree possible within the limits of Islamic laws. Sometimes Qata al-Rahm is allowed in certain circumstances. For example, if Silat al-Rahm towards a sinful Muslim relative provides them with the opportunity to sin more, then this kind of Silat al-Rahm is forbidden. Qata al-Rahm also becomes wajib if it discourages a Muslim relative from their sinful ways. According to narrations, one who breaks ties with family reduces his lifespan, and in the hereafter awaits him even more severe punishment. According to Imam Jafar as-Sadiq, Silat al-Rahm perfects our character. Through repeated and continuous kindness towards our relatives, our morals are refined and kindness for others becomes part of our nature. And in this manner, our soul is also purified. Imam Jafar as-Sadiq also said, "Kindness to our relatives makes the accounting of the hereafter easy." And in numerous reports from the Ahlul Bayt, they mentioned that Silat al-Rahm increases a person's life, delays their death, and increases their sustenance.